Hey guys, thank you for joining me in today's video. My name is Alyssa, and I am the artist and calligrapher behind Lissa's Letters. And today, I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. So recently in my Instagram stories, I made a post where I asked you guys to submit a piece of artwork that you would be interested in receiving feedback on. And in particular, I was interested in looking at artwork from beginner lettering artists. I ended up getting a whole bunch of submissions, so thank you to everybody who did submit a piece of artwork. But unfortunately, I just couldn't go through every single one and give feedback. So I ended up picking just a few pieces of artwork, and we're going to be going through them today in this video. This first quote was lettered by Cass from Calligraphy with Cass, and it says, "Less perfection, more authenticity." I love this quote. So the first thing that I did was I took a screenshot and input it into Procreate and increased the contrast so that the letters are in black and the background is in white. Right off the bat, I love that she's made some bold choices with her flourishes, and she's made the more important words, perfection and authenticity, larger and have a thicker line weight. But there were a few things about these letters that I wanted to adjust. So first of all, I noticed that some of the downstrokes were much thicker than the others. So if we kind of zoom in here, we can see that this letter C is a lot thinner than the letter N. So that's something we're gonna wanna change. I also noticed that the letters are not all oriented on the same slant. So you can see that the letters in the bottom word are for the most part oriented straight up and down. But then in the word perfection, you can see here the P is oriented going downward from left to right. And then some of the other letters are actually slanted in the complete opposite direction. So basically we just want to pick one direction. Either the letters are going to go oriented left to right to left, or just straight up and down. And then the final characteristic of these big letters that I felt needed work was letter height. So typically we want all of the lowercase letters to be the same height, but I was noticing that some were taller, some were shorter, and overall this just made it look a little bit uneven. So with the help of the drawing grid on Procreate, I made these two pink lines that are acting as the baseline, which is where all of the lowercase letters are going to sit on top of. And then for each of the words, I drew another line on top of the baseline, which will be called our X height. And that's going to be where the top of the little lowercase letters is going to reach. So we're just going to make sure that every single lowercase letter has the same height, and I made it the same for both perfection and authenticity. So now that I had identified what areas I wanted to work on with the letters, I lowered the opacity of that first layer so I could sketch the letters on top, focusing on keeping them going straight up and down and having the same height and letter thickness. I did my best to retain the original style of Cass's letters, and whenever possible, I just traced over exactly what she had. I decided to move the word authenticity down a little bit just so I would have a little bit more space to work on it, and then I could always move it back up later if I felt like that would be the best decision for the spacing between the words, but it was helpful just to have enough space between them while I'm just working on the letters here. So you can see here what the letters look like. They're straight up and down, they're a lot more even, and they're all the same height. And you can also see how they look in comparison to the original. And without the flourishes, without the gold color, it does look a little bit boring. But also, I felt at this point that the letters looked kind of dull being just straight up and down and not having any curvature or slant to them. So I decided that I would go in and make it a little bit more my style by adding some curvature to the downstrokes. The letters are still oriented on a straight up and down slant, but now they have just a little bit more character, where the downstrokes are somewhat more C-shaped. And I think it just gives it a little bit of, I don't know, like a personality. It's a little more fun. And you can really see the difference when I toggle back and forth between the two. All right, now I identified these three big areas between the words where I'll want to fill in the space using flourishes. And just as Cass did in her original piece, I thought it would be perfect to use the crossbars of the letters T to make those flourishes in between the words. And I also added a flourish onto the bottom of the letter Y, which is something that she also had in her original piece. But in the original, I noticed that the flourish underneath the word authenticity only went to about halfway under the word on the right side, and then there was kind of this empty space on the other side, and I thought it would be perfect to make it a little bit more symmetrical by adding another flourish. So I extended the stem of that letter T you see me working on right here down below the word, and I made a little flourish coming off of that to nicely mirror the flourish coming off of the stem of the Y. I incorporated a nice long S-shaped crossbar on the T in the word perfection, just as Cass had in her original version. And I did my best to make sure that it had the same overall style as the other flourishes that I had already made in the piece. So the other ones that I've already made were quite round rather than straight. And also I wanted to kind of match the amount of space, or the amount of negative space, that was present throughout the piece. So above the O, there was a little bit too much negative space where there wasn't, you know, anything going on. So I added a little extra curve on that flourish to fill out that space. At this point, I liked how it looked, and I wanted to add the word less above perfection, just centered, just like I had done with the word more. But it felt unbalanced overall once I added the crossbar of the T to the word perfection. So I decided to add another flourish to the word perfection to make it a little bit more symmetrical. And I did that by taking the ascender loop of the letter F and extending it out. By the way, if you're interested in learning how to make all different types of flourishes like these for your lettering, I actually teach a class on Skillshare called Flourishing Made Simple. It comes with more than 35 printable worksheets and more than 2 hours of video lessons, so make sure you check that out. I'll have a link in the description for this video down below. So why did I choose to center the words less and more in this piece? You'll notice in the original that Cass put them kind of off to the side, and there's really no particular reason why I decided to make them centered, other than it makes it easier to read. The words get a little bit less lost when they're in the center. And here's how the digital revised draft looked when I added the gold letters and black background. I'm really happy with it because I feel like I was able to maintain the original feel that Cass had in the piece while still adding a little bit of my own style. By the way, if you just noticed a sudden change in my voice, it's because a couple weeks have passed since I did the first part of recording the voiceover for this video. I took a little break from it, and right now my voice is a little bit congested, so that's what that is. So moving on, this next piece is by an artist named Zay, or Zai, I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but I like Zai, so we'll say that. So just as I did with the first piece, to make the process easier for me, I made the background white and the letters in black. I also added the drawing grid, which you can kind of see on the screen. It's those like little squares, to make it easier for me to see how tall and wide each of the letters are. And there goes my voice. Okay, hopefully it holds up for the rest of this video. So you can see what I'm doing right now is I'm trying to make sure that all of the letters have the same height and that they're all on the same slant. So Xi did a pretty good job of this, but Procreate is allowing me to ensure that it's really spot on. I went through all of the letters using this technique, making sure they're on the same slant and have the same height. And you'll notice that I didn't do any flourishes or loops in this first part because I like to have my letters in place before I add anything fancy. And in this case, I'm really glad I did that because once I wrote out all the letters, I noticed that there were some variations in spacing, meaning some of the letters were really close together, like here in positivity, the P and the O were really close together and the O was really close to the S. So I took some time to spread out letters that needed to be spread out and just make sure that the spacing between all of the letters was as even as I could make it. Now to get that nice modern calligraphy look with thick downstrokes and thinner upstrokes, I used Xi's original piece as a reference and I basically just did faux calligraphy. Oh, I forgot to mention that when I was writing out the letters, I did keep a little bit of a bounce to them. So you'll notice that the stems of some of the letters don't go down to the baseline. They actually go a little bit below the baseline. That's called bounce lettering. And it's just a fun technique to kind of make sure the letters look fun and fluid and not rigid. So now for my favorite part, which is adding in flourishes. Designing flourishes for a piece is such a creative exploration, and there really are infinite possibilities for the types of flourishes that you can do for any given piece. So I decided to look back at Xi's original composition to give me some inspiration for the flourishes that I was going to use, but I knew I wanted it to be a little bit different than what she had originally done, just so I could make sure that the spacing was totally even throughout. Gosh, I could take like 2 hours just telling you about why I decided to make the flourishes the way I did in this piece and what my design process was. It is quite complicated, and that's why I made a whole Skillshare class about designing flourishes. So definitely check that out if you want to figure out kind of what my thought process is when I design my flourishes. But basically, I was just trying to make sure that the amount of negative space between the letters, between the words, and in any area is even. So there's not any area that has too much white space and not any area that's too clumped. You may notice that in the original version, towards the left, so between the capital R and the capital P, it's quite dense with a lot of black. And then between the two words, there's quite a lot of white space. In the revised version, I actually brought the two words closer together so that there's less white space between the two words, and I just eliminated the little flourish coming off of the little tail of the letter R. And here's a side-by-side comparison with the original on the left and the revised version on the right, just so you can see what I was talking about. And of course, the piece would not be complete without the fun red and orange background that Xi had already created. Not gonna lie, and a lot of you guys already know this, but I really don't like the color red, but I added it back in because I feel like it's just such an important part of this piece and really brings it to life. Oh, also, I decided to add a little white highlight to the right side of each letter to make it easier to read because sometimes black letters against a very vibrant red background, there's not enough contrast, so it's a little bit more difficult to read. So that white added that little pop of contrast, and I'm happy that I added it. I think it's important to note that the reason why I picked each of these three pieces to work on was because there was something that I really liked about each one, and they each had their own strengths. And I also saw the potential to kind of insert my own style into each of them. So for example, this last piece, which was by the Cali Girl, I think it is, I thought this was a really great piece. I really liked the way she did the lettering. I love the contrast of the really thick downstrokes and the thinner upstrokes. I think the letters are just so fun, like such fun shapes, and I love that she did color on a black background. I didn't really feel like there was anything that needed to be changed about this piece, but I thought that maybe I could tighten things up a little bit and make the composition a little bit more my own style. The first thing I wanted to do was to center all of the text, because at the top of the composition, it seemed as though the words, like she was trying to make them all centered, but then towards the bottom, it's like she couldn't decide whether she wanted the words to be centered or not. So I just decided, let's just make them all centered. I thought that this was a nice improvement to the piece because it makes it look like it's more intentional where the words are placed. But I thought that I would kind of bring things to the next level by really getting nitpicky about the spacing between letters. So notice here there's kind of a big empty space between the word being and creative, but then there's an area where things are a little bit more tight and there's not as much empty space. When I'm working on my own pieces of artwork and trying to get letters to fit into one another, I like to think of it as a puzzle where the pieces all have to kind of fit together and the letters still have to be legible. It's kind of a fun little exercise, and the more I do it, the better I get at it, but I'm not perfect. And you know, it was just a fun little creative endeavor for this piece to work on the letters and see different ways that I could get them to fit together. Right now you might be thinking, but Alyssa, in the other two pieces you just showed us, you were so careful about making sure that all of the letters were the same height and had the same baseline. And in this piece, you're trying to make all the letters different heights and have different baselines. Yes, that is true. And that's why this is a little bit more of an advanced style, because I am trying to make the letters really bouncy, and I didn't want the look of everything to be kind of lined up perfectly. The key is really consistency. In the first two pieces that I worked on in this video, it looked as though the artists were trying to make all of the letters the same, but that, you know, there were a few outliers. And in this piece, I noticed that, you know, the word creative already had kind of a bouncy style to it. So I thought, why not just exaggerate that and then carry that style over to the other letters in the piece? Speaking of consistency, you may have noticed that I eliminated the serifs on the letter C. A serif is basically just an extra stroke. It's not necessary for you to read the letter. Basically, there were very few letters in this piece that had serifs other than the C and the H, which you saw me just erase just now. And my personal preference is either to use serifs on every single letter in a word or no letters in a word. So I just wanted to keep it consistent. Going through and revising each of these pieces of artwork took several hours and is actually part of the reason why I have not been as prolific recently with creating my own colorful pieces of artwork that I post on Instagram, but it was actually really enjoyable for me to go through and edit these pieces and kind of put them into my own style. I hope that by sharing the process with you guys in a video gives you some things to think about when you're doing your own lettering compositions. But also keep in mind that no matter what level of a lettering artist you are, it is never about being perfect, because there is no such thing. And really what's most important is your personal preferences and what you think looks beautiful. For each piece of artwork in this video, whether you preferred the original version or the revised version, take the opportunity to notice which aspects of each piece you did and did not like, because that will help you grow as an artist. So one last thing I wanted to mention, I've been working for quite some time, maybe a few months, on creating another Skillshare class, and it's going to be on lettering compositions. And my goal for it is to basically build off of what we've covered in today's video, which has been the basics of creating a coherent lettering composition. Okay, I actually meant the word cohesive, not coherent, but they're very similar words, so I can see how I would make that mistake. Anyway, that class, it's just taking me a while to make because I want it to be engaging and interesting, but I also want it to reflect my current skills. I started recording footage for it back in April of 2020, and it is now December, and I'm just not at the same place that I was back in April. I'm very proud to say that I have grown as an artist, and I want my class to help you guys grow in the same way that I have grown. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me in today's video, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye!